The Philippine Finance Chief meets with top World Bank officials in Washington, D.C. Secretary Ralph Recto held talks with officials of the financial group at the sidelines of the spring meetings this week in the U.S. Capitol. There, the Finance Department said the World Bank pledged support for the Marcos administration's key projects. These include digitalization efforts to improve tax collection efficiency, speeding up the rollout of flagship infrastructure projects, and the reskilling of workers to improve the labor force. The World Bank also offered aid for the Philippines' agriculture sector to address food security. The American Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines confident about growth prospects of the Philippine economy. Sarah Murphy told ANC a lot of proof shows promise of the economy, including the recent U.S. trade mission to Manila, as well as the leaders' summit between the U.S., Japan, and the Philippines. She adds, aside from the BPO industry, which she remains bullish about, there are other economic pillars emerging in the coming years.
Obviously, there's a lot of buzz right now about renewable energy, mining, manufacturing. There's continued room for growth, as you know, our BPAP team and Jack Madrid has said. You know, we're continuing to be bullish and have a pretty aggressive roadmap to 2028. You know, I think, you know, we need to continue to be in tune with the changing needs of our workforce. Technology is bringing advancements, and so I think, you know, as we look at the future of work coming out of the pandemic, return to office mandates and such, I just, you know, I really encourage everyone to be open to listening and being open to trying new things and adjusting, getting it right and getting it wrong sometimes, and just continuing to kind of persevere. But I'm incredibly optimistic about the future of the BPO industry here.
Meralco consumers may experience rotating power interruptions due to the red alert on the Luzon grid. The power distributor says it may implement a one-hour manual load dropping between 2 p.m. and 4 p.m., affecting around 660,000 service accounts. The Energy Department, meanwhile, assures the public it is coordinating with power stakeholders to minimize the impact of the red alert. It adds it has instructed distribution utilities to activate their interruptible load program. The program entails participants to use their own generating facilities to help reduce overall demand on the grid.
The Philippines' tax man has granted a 90-day extension to online sellers to comply with the withholding tax system. The new revenue regulation mandates the implementation of a withholding tax system for transactions made by online sellers through electronic marketplace operators and digital financial services. This is part of government's effort to regulate and tax online transactions. BAR Commissioner Romeo Lumagi Jr. notes, while the industry has grown during and after the pandemic, many online merchants are still not paying the right amount of taxes.
Growth in the world's second largest economy was put at 5.3% in the first quarter. That expansion rate, fueled by improved manufacturing, widely beating expectations of just 4.2%. While it offers relief now for policymakers, a raft of economic data in March suggests still fragile growth and raises questions on sustainability. This was a sentiment shared by a Chinese statistics official who said a foundation for stable growth is not yet solid and the property market remains a concern.
Overall, the national economy had a good start in the first quarter, with accumulated positive factors laying a good foundation for achieving annual targets. However, it is essential to recognize the increasing complexity, severity, and uncertainty of the external environment.
Here's how the market reacted to China's first quarter growth. Markets in Shanghai and Hong Kong both down by 1 and 2% respectively. Joining them in Tuesday's free fall, Japan's Nikkei 225 and South Korea's Kospi Index. Aside from economic news from China, investors are also closely watching developments in the Middle East. The latest today, Israeli forces vowing retaliation to Iran's weekend missile and drone strike. Foreign ministers of the elite group of seven nations are also meeting this week to seek ways to contain the conflict.